His car went airborne at more than 300 miles an hour, but he's here to tell the story of how he survived and why he keeps on racing. That's next.
Trusted name in news.
We have saved the fastest for last. Jake and Dario are still with me, but before I get to guest number three, Tony Schumacher, let's take a look at just one of the crashes he's lived to tell about. And keep in mind, his car was traveling at over 300 miles an hour when it all happened. Watch. Joining us from Chicago, Tony Schumacher. He survived that horrific 300-mile-an-hour crash. That was at the Memphis Motorsports Park in the year 2000. He's four-time National Hot Rod Association Powerade World Champion. He's been sponsored by the United States Army since 2000. What happened there, Tony?
On that particular crash, the rear wing or the spoiler came off the car at 320 miles an hour. And, you know, as any race car driver knows, you lose that rear wing or any wing on a race car, and they take flight and it gets pretty ugly. And unfortunately, on that particular crash, the car flew over the wall, and that's very unlikely. It happens maybe two or three times since I've been, you know, watching racing. And it was a bad time. It was a horrific crash. And the only reason I survived that is because we had an incredibly talented safety safari on the NHRA circuit, and they saved my life.
How injured were you?
I broke my left fibula in six places. I dislocated my fingers. Pretty serious concussion. And I was awake through the crash. It was extremely noisy. It was very violent. 2 weeks later, I was screwed back together. My leg was put back together by great doctors in Indianapolis that actually follow the IndyCar circuit. And they put me back together. We were fighting for a championship. And not that I wanted to be back in the car in 2 weeks, but we were back in that car. It was pretty intense.
Why do you hot rod?
Well, I wake up every morning like the two before. I can't wait to get in a race car, and I'm sure Jake can't wait to get on a skateboard. I think we have a gift that we get to do what we love to do, and you know it's.
But why? It's, why that form of vehicle?
You know, I love all forms of racing. I really do. I drive some stock cars. I actually spent a lot of time at the Richard Petty School. I went through Skip Barber years ago, and I love it all. I really do. It's. This is a. To me, it's an 8,000 horsepower car, the most intense form of racing. It's 4 seconds, 337 miles an hour, no room for mistakes, no pit crews doing a tune-up in the middle to fix a car. It's a pretty much big moment every time you get in that car. You got 4 seconds.
No.
It's awesome.
No turns.
Well, I had a pretty good turn there, but you don't want to do that.
All right, now let's get the others. Dario, what do you think of the method Tony uses to travel?
I watch Tony and John Force and all the guys that race the dragsters, and I think it's an incredibly intense form of motorsport, maybe the most intense. And just watching that wreck there, it's amazing. And the thing that I guess we have in common is that desire to get back in the car. And you know, I've got a race this weekend in Kentucky, and there's been times before screw me back together, put me back in the car, and I guess when that desire goes away, you get out of the car and go do something else.
Jake, what do you think of what Tony does?
That crash was unbelievable. I couldn't even tell what part he was in of the car still. It looked like there was nothing left.
All right, now Dario can't wait to race again this week. Are you anxious to get back on skates?
Yeah, definitely. I can't wait to skate again. It's going to be a few weeks for me, maybe a month. But I'm going to just go heavily to the doctors and just get
back. Tony, how long before you came back after that?
I was back in that car.